the Caribbean, the island of Jamaica, St. Anne's Bay. Not far from the beach where Columbus first landed on the island, Marcus Garvey was born August 17, 1887. At that time, Jamaica was a British colony. A small minority of white colonial masters ruled over a black majority. To be white was to be rich, to be black was to be poor. Although slavery had been abolished more than 50 years before, the white man remained the master and the black man the servant as the 19th century came to a close. Most Jamaicans lived off the land. Their forefathers had been captured and brought from Africa to work as slaves on the sugar plantations. After the abolition of slavery in 1833, most of the former slaves wanted to own and farm their own land. But the only plots they were able to obtain were on the rocky hillsides, and so many of them were once again forced to work on the plantations as laborers. Marcus Garvey described the black man's condition in this way.
In Jamaica, black men have no special advantages. You are slated to be a cowhand or laborer, a blacksmith or shoemaker. I looked at the system that man fixed for me, and I said, this does not suit me.
But only a few thought along the same lines. Most Jamaicans did not question the rigid social hierarchy based on color and race. Without a protest, they carried their produce to be sold abroad for the benefit of Mother England. A few managed to move forward within the strict social order. They became tradesmen or skilled workers. St. Anne's Bay today. The small market town has a population of about 2,000, and its main source of income is agriculture and the pepper trade. There is not much tourism here, and the famous son, Marcus Garvey, has not yet been shamelessly exploited by his native town. Little has changed in St. Anne's Bay since Garvey was a child. Many of the old houses still stand, and people are still living in them. St. Anne's Bay was once a major port. Peppers were shipped from here all over the world. Today, Kingston has replaced St. Anne's Bay, and the once busy port has become a sleepy little market town. Marcus Garvey remembers his childhood here.
To me, at home in my early days, there was no difference between white and black. One of my father's properties, the place where I lived most of the time, was adjoining that of a white man. He had three girls and two boys. The Wesleyan minister, another white man whose church my parents attended, also had property adjoining ours. He had three girls and one boy. All of us were playmates. The little white girl, whom I liked most, knew no better than I did myself. We were two innocent fools who never dreamed of a race feeling and problem. At 14, my little white playmate and I were parted. Her parents sent her to Scotland and told her that she was never to write or try and get in touch with me, for I was a nigger. It was then that I found for the first time that there was some difference in humanity and that there were different races, each having its own separate and distinct social life.
Isaac Samuel Rose is over 100 years old. He recalls his school days. When I go to school, me and he go to Wesleyan Church, and there I sit upon the platform there, and they sing a hymn and read psalms. But the boys was rude boys, and they write a note and drop it to the girls, and the girls read them, and laugh So the parson send Marcus' father to keep the boys them in order. And he sit down, and the cool breeze take him, and he fall asleep with his mouth open. And the boys them make a cigar out of paper, and they light it, and they put it in his mouth. So Marcus was beside me, and I saw them laugh, so I turned around to look, and I touched Marcus to show him. So Marcus picked up Saunders and fling him down the staircase. Everybody look up and thought Saunders dead. Kingston, the capital of Jamaica at the turn of the century. Marcus Garvey came here in 1905 to work as an apprentice in one of the biggest printing plants in town. Kingston was not only the most important harbor of the island, it was also the place in which a newly conscious working class was developing. For a young man coming from the country, Kingston offered a new and exciting experience. The streets were crowded and the rhythm of life was fast and hectic. It was in Kingston that Garvey first came into conflict with the new black middle class. Garvey wrote,
"Representative and educated Negroes have made the mistake of drawing and keeping themselves away from race, thinking that it is degrading and ignominious to identify themselves with the masses of the people who are still ignorant and backward, but who are crying out for true and conscientious leadership."
In 1907, Garvey organized a printer's strike and lost his job.
"I saw the injustice done to my race because it was black. I went traveling to South and Central America and parts of the West Indies, and I found the same situation. I set sail for Europe, and again I found the stumbling block, you are black. After I returned in 1914, I founded the UNIA, the Universal Negro Improvement Association."
Monroe Scarlett, a former associate.
"What you would call a welfare cultural society. As Marcus Garvey said, it was necessary for people to work on their own behalf. Naturally, we were British subjects, but that didn't impair the fact that we were people of African descent. And it was necessary for the black man, and by black man that meant the people of African descent, you know what that covers, to have an interest in themselves and in the coming into being of the new day of Africa's renaissance."
"I never really knew there was so much color prejudice in Jamaica until I started the work of the UNIA. Men and women as black as I, and even more so, had believed themselves white under the West Indian order of society. And I had to decide whether to please my friends and be one of the black whites of Jamaica and be reasonably prosperous, or come out openly and defend and help improve and protect the integrity of the black medians and suffer. I decided to do the latter."
In search of a wider field to realize his ideas, Marcus Garvey went to the United States in 1916. Harlem.